My brother had like when he was in college, he had like a kind of a frat house. They weren't in a frat. They were actually one of the ones that like dressed, put the paint on their face before football games. In Texas, it's called Hellraisers. Yeah, but anyway, okay. And he had made his own. Yeah, I don't think it was for exercise though. So.
Probably not.
It's not as easy as it looks, and then you just look like an idiot.
It's a specific skill set.
I had the one excuse, the only time I've ever done that is in a vehicle that had one. It was like the first time the cast and I all went out to dinner, and they got us a party bus. That's like encouraging us to be stupid. So, and we were drinking on the party bus and all of that. So at one point, me and JB, who's like, a mess. Anyway, we're doing that. Both of us, like, I was, like, all the way at the very top, and he's, like, down at the bottom at one point, and I was just like, we look ridiculous, and thank God I fell a couple times, but I could at least say that.
Did you take a vote?
That was because of the car. I would have won, I'm sure, but JB has a very sensitive soul, so.
But you probably didn't look ridiculous to a bunch of people in the
It was just the cast, and they all thought it was pretty ridiculous, yeah.
Really?
So, but I don't mind making a fool of myself.
So they're not quite as hard, the partiers, as they appear to be?
We're not at all. At all. Like, a couple of times when we get together, we all hang out. We'll maybe drink or a little bit, but.
No shots off of anybody's belly? Or
absolutely not. No limes making out with the mouth and the tongue. No.
Yeah. Well, I guess it would be like family at some point. It'd be a little gross.
Yeah, it is gross. It's weird. It's weird, especially because, yeah, we all know way too much about each other. Yeah.
So how did you gather? I mean, it's interesting that you guys went out on the party bus. That was the first gathering of the whole cast?
It was, yeah. I think Joel Silver had decided to take us all out to dinner. So we had to go all the way to, I think, Santa Monica to the Benihana over there. Anyway, yeah, we went to Benihana. It was amazing. Anyway. We all, yeah, got to ride in the body bus, which is amazing.
And was there a table reading before that or anything? Or
oh, No.
Was it like you just picked each other up, like it was the real world or?
Oh God. No, we had met before then. No, I thought you meant was there a table read the day of or like the next morning that we were worried about? No, not at all. But yeah, we had met before. We had gone through the whole casting process. Mm-hmm. So, but that was the first time we all got to let loose.
So, and now you're legal.
Yes.
Were you legal when you were hanging from the pole in the car?
Technically, no.
Technically, no. That'd be a technically no.
That'd be a technically
no. I'm sure you didn't have anything at all to drink then at that
point. Absolutely not.
Of course not. So, you come from Texas?
Yes. Yes.
What you and you've been here about 5 years or?
No. I guess for good. Maybe it's more like 7. I think actually, because I came out here when I was like 14. I think so.
So you just. Loaded up the truck and moved to Beverly, or what? How does that work for you?
I mean, my mom and I had an agent in Houston, and they had one of those like agency review type things. And an agent from LA basically said, you know, you should come out. You have to at least come out for like a month if you want to actually do it, and just see what happens. And that's what we did. We'd come out for like a month at a time, but then I'd get really close on something, or I'd get a call back, and then we'd have to leave. And at one point, we just decided to pack up our stuff. And I'm the youngest, so my mom, you know, she had to quit her job still, which was difficult, but.
How many of you?
There's, I have an older brother, Brady, and then I have step-siblings as well. So, I have 3 other step-siblings as well, so.
So a full house?
A full house, yeah.
So was it always acting, or was it modeling, or?
There was a little bit of modeling and, like, commercial acting stuff, because that's all they did in Houston. Mm-hmm. That's all I knew. And then my agency in Houston opened up like an acting division where we kind of got to, you know, read sides and actually do some acting as opposed to, you know, I love Jiffy Peanut Butter, which I did that.
They still have Jiffy Peanut Butter or Jif Peanut Butter?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I have some.
And you get a case of it every year for
your... No, that was just something that we practiced. I didn't do that commercial, actually. That was like a one that we practiced.
Because that's like when they bring it out, like you're very famous, and all of a sudden your Jif commercial shows up from 20 years ago. No.
Trust me, if that's going to happen, then I should get clean and clear for free for the rest of my life.
What is clean and clear?
It's face wash. Okay. But, so yeah, I did a couple of those. I've done a lot, man. I should get Ross shoes. I should... Anyway, but yeah.
So did you take to acting immediately, or was that
something you liked? Yeah, it was fun. It was a lot more, I think trying to sell something is only fun for a little bit because you're always smiling and always kind of being manipulative. And so I thought being comedic or being dramatic was something that was fun mm-hmm. for me to do.
So did you study or did you just kind of take to it?
No, absolutely. I mean, when you come out here, you're kind of told to study. You're kind of, every mm-hmm. agent you go to has a list of people that they want you to meet with. And when you're younger, the classes are what everybody meets. I have done a bunch of classes. Mm-hmm. I don't do it as much anymore, especially now that what I do is kind of more like, especially for Project X, it was all kind of improv and stuff like that. And you can't really prepare yourself for that. You kind of can or can't. Mm-hmm. So.
So it's all kind of based on your personality at that point.
Yeah, I mean, especially for this film. Yeah, it was easy for me to do because she's a tomboy and she's one of the guys. And then I knew the storyline, so then mm-hmm. I just kind of played around from there.
So when you came out, was it all Disney Channel and
Nick and Knight, I was like 16, so that's all I could do. I did Nickelodeon and Disney Channel, all of those. Yeah, the first thing I ever did was Unfabulous, which is an Emma Roberts show. She was like, oh, we were all so young. Anyway, I still have friends I'm young still, but I was like really young. And I still have, Fred Savage directed one of the episodes that I did, which is hilarious. But I still have friends from that show, actually.
So is there like a circle of kids who are that age? And
that if you've been around for a long time, yeah, you get to know everybody, especially if you start doing well in the industry, because it comes down to like the same 4 or 5 girls, if you're blonde and blue-eyed or whatever, you know, you see the same people all the time. So yeah, it's funny, you run into the same people a lot.
So do you get sick of being blonde-haired and blue-eyed at times? Or do you,
I can't really change that now just because it's kind of a part of what I'm, I don't know, what I'm doing now. So, mm-hmm. But I definitely want to go brunette at some point. So.
Just for real life.
Change and for real life. But
do you think it affects how you can work?
Or? Absolutely. It affects how I'm perceived as well. So it's funny, if I wear my hair up, there's no way that you can even tell that I'm the same girl in the movie. It's just like, you can't really put two and two together. So I'm not going to change my hair to do anything too drastic until I've got a more, you know, a body of work.
So does it change when you become a woman as opposed to a kid actor in terms of how you're
I would like to think of a
fitting
woman
into
now.
This town?
You're 21. I'd like to think of, yeah, exactly. Yeah, I think for me it also has to do with I want to be kind of established already for some, as you know, I want to have more work before I actually change my appearance too much.
Mm-hmm. But I mean, does it change? Does how the business sees you change? Have you felt like Project X is kind of a coming out for you in some way?
Yeah, absolutely. I went to an audition the other day and all they were talking about was like the movie and how successful it was, and it's pretty easy to jump into my sides after, you know, they just told me how great my movie was and how they had liked it, and you know, I deserve all of this success. And I was just like, wow, okay, great. I'm used to going into auditions and being like, so you want me to start now or so
how did you get into Project X?
I didn't go about it through the nationwide talent search way. I kind of went around.
There was a nationwide talent search for Project X?
Yes. Todd wanted unknowns, and then he wanted maybe even not actors. Mm-hmm. So, but I at the time was an actor, so, but I didn't have that much credits, which finally came in handy for me. he didn't want, a lot of my friends that were, you know, doing well at that time wanted to get in an audition, and he didn't want anyone that had, you know, been seen before or
you didn't
film
have Kirby exclamation point on
exactly.
the show on Nickelodeon.
Exactly.
So you went in for an audition and it was just like a normal audition, or was it?
I mean, the sides at that point were very vague and we didn't know anything about the project. So it was very hush hush. All we knew was that Todd Phillips was involved and Joel Silver, and that was kind of enough.
And they weren't lingering in the room.
Oh, no. No. The first time I saw Todd, I was like so nervous, but he was in the room. Like, I auditioned like 10 or 12 times. So he was in the room like later on, once it got narrowed down more.
So was there already a question which person you were up for?
Yeah, at one point I was actually up for Alexis's character. Mm-hmm. And I was going to be the hot girl and someone else was going to be the kind of girl next door. And we did a table read, like we had already been cast, everything. Huh. And we did a table read and they kind of just felt like I was more like one of the guys. So... Huh. Yeah, they changed everything around, moved everybody around, and then brought in Alexis to be the hot girl.
So is that weird for you, or is that like, do you feel hot demoted, or?
No, not at all. I think I have a meteor part, so I don't mind.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
So do you think it was just the vibe in the room that you guys were going to be improvising and you liked each other?
Or? Yeah, absolutely. We all got along really well, and it just didn't seem right for me to be the mean girl at school, which I understand. I'll take that.
So have you played the mean girl in other things, or you played?
Yeah, just because I think that, you know, the cliche blonde cheerleader girl has been done so many times. I think that once I walk in, that's what they kind of expect, and then I open my mouth, and it's kind of different. So, but I think, all of the younger stuff when I was younger, that's all I went out for, was like the mean, popular girl at school. So.
So you get tired of that after a while?
Yeah. I mean, cause it's kind of all the same, but, it's similar cause there are those cliche cliques. I was definitely not that girl in high school, but I knew that girl in high school and she's. Mm-hmm.
And now you're kind of thumbing your nose at her?
I don't know what that
expression means. She's trying to graduate,
but,
huh? Oh.
Thumbing your nose.
Mocking her.
Oh, okay. No,
From a distance, from the screen.
I feel okay with how everything turned out.
So what was the process like? I mean, Todd was involved before. Did you see Todd before you saw your director? How did they work together?
They worked really well together. Todd wasn't on set all the time, but when he was there, he was very hands-on, which is important because we were all very, you know, this is his name that, you know, he's putting this out there. So he was definitely, it's like his baby. He was there. But then at one point, and he even said this in an interview, that he just kind of had to let it go too, because this is Nima's debut, directorial debut. So, you know, you just kind of got to let the director do what he wants to do. And he's not going to feel as much freedom if Todd's there, you know, looking around. So they worked really well together, though. And visually, I think it came out perfect because comedic-wise, we have all the same beats, and Todd, you know, gave us great advice, and he would just out of nowhere just be like, hey, say this, and I'm like, what? Oh, my God, okay. And then visually, you know, Nima knew exactly what to do to get the right, you know,
right
feel, which I feel the vibe of the whole movie is very, I don't know, it's like a music video, but hardcore.
Well, visually, I mean, I guess the idea is for it to look like found footage, but it also looks extremely composed.
Exactly. Very well done. Exactly. So I like that fact because I've been asked a bunch of times, am I going to be sick, or, you know, because there's that whole blurry aspect or the shaky thing, which I don't really like. I don't come to the movie theater to feel ill. unless I eat too much popcorn.
So few people do.
Something. So, yeah.
And then they see Adam Sandler.
I like the aspect that it is really fun and easy to watch as well.
Well, was shooting it complicated? I mean, did it feel like you were on a documentary, or did it feel like you were?
No, not really. No, it felt like I was on a movie set, but the camera's not up in your face, which is kind of fun because, you know, when there's lights and camera, you're like, oh yeah, I'm shooting a movie. But it, like, a couple of times the camera was like way over there and like hiding behind the door because it's supposed to be an actual character.
Right.
And if we're not knowing that he's there and he's like sneaking in or whatever, we're not supposed to acknowledge him. Mm-hmm. So he has to kind of hide, which is funny because then the camera's not in my face and I don't have a light in my face, and it makes it more kind of intimate and organic. And I don't have to worry about, you know, oh, I wonder, oh, you know.
A lot of takes?
No, not really. And then it was just kind of, okay, next. Because this was a really kind of small movie that was made to be very big, I guess. Mm-hmm. It got much bigger. So we realized that we needed to do reshoots and that it was going to be a lot to redo, because when there was the fire and the water, I mean, that was hard to do. And I think everybody kind of underestimated how much time and effort all that was going to take. I mean, we had like over 200 extras, and they're all like coughing and like couldn't breathe, and I'm like, oh my God. I wasn't there for that, but I heard that it was nuts. So I don't know, we had to make a lot of stuff happen real quick. So
did you have a sense of what the movie was going to be when it was cut together? I mean,
he did this thing like, I guess 2 weeks in, maybe. He had cut together like a little montage, and that's the only thing that gave me an idea. And it literally, parts of it looks exactly like the trailer that you see now. And it just looks like a music video, but like very visually stunning, you know? So I was really excited. I mean, anything that makes me look like a rock star, I'm down for. So, I mean, we all looked like we were having a really good time, and I don't know, it was just, it was really fun. It wasn't even any of, like, the scenes, actually. It was literally right. just cut together pieces of us partying and music in the background. But I was impressed, so.
Well, you have to be a little bit more of the straight woman through the middle of this.
The straight woman?
Be you have to be not having as much fun, I guess.
Oh, yeah. I mean, she did have a good time. She got to go into the pool and all of that. But then she walks in and gets pissed and has to leave. So.
And it was almost like you walking in on yourself.
Not at all.
Your former character.
Yeah, yeah. But I don't look like that naked, so.
So is that an issue for you?
Walking in on her naked?
No, in the movie, you were going to play this role where there seemed to be...
No, well, that was never, we never even got to that point, you know, talking about the nudity part, because that was more once, you know, they had already decided not to do that, kind of, once I had read, so.
So is that something you don't want to do, or do you do want to do, or you don't care, or you're not sure, or?
That's something I've not really thought about.
Well, you would think that it would be a popular conversation with producers, no?
Ew,
It's good that you're still saying ooh, but I mean you are 21 now, and you were 18 3 years ago.
Yes, that's correct.
A lot of movies where they, you know, the pretty girl thing is.
Yeah, I have turned down times. I've turned it down because I don't think it's right to do it in a comedy. Okay. Like,
so you actually want it to mean something if you're going to do something.
I guess, but I don't even know then. I don't really know if I don't know if that has anything to do with my talent.
Do you think about this stuff? I mean, is this something that's really like on your plate of a career and how you see it?
No, I try not to think about stuff until it comes along, because if I worry about every decision that I'll have to make, which then I'll drive myself crazy.
So you don't have like a 5-year where you want to be in 5 years? Or?
No, I have plans. I definitely am very picky. In fact, I get in trouble for just being like, ugh, I don't really like that script, or ugh, I don't know about that character a lot, because I'm very... I have a certain thing that, you know, I want to come out as. I've got an idea of what I want to, you know, do. Mm-hmm. But no, I mean, because if I still might do television. I still might do some small indie films. I still mm-hmm. might do. So it just depends on what comes around. I can't plan everything out ahead of time, because that'll end up me getting, you know, stuck on this idea of doing film. And then a TV show is going to come around and I'll be like, I don't know what to do, you know, when really I should take it, because work's work.
So what is it that makes you excited about doing something?
The character is important, obviously, the story as well. Mm-hmm. And then if it's something different, I think I read a lot, and I think that finding something unique is very, very hard right now. But that's why I'm so excited that I got to come out in this, because it's mm-hmm. extremely unique and it's all unknowns and it's shot differently. It's the first time a comedy is shot in found footage, so... I'm also looking for something as unique as what I just did, you know.
So are you looking for something, is unique the thing that is something that you haven't seen or something you haven't done?
I like looking for that, yeah.
Do you get nervous about doing your work? Do you feel like there are things, that challenges that you can't do, or
yeah,
you're not
absolutely.
Sure you can do?
The crying stuff is still like the hardest thing, especially going into an audition and having to do it. Mm-hmm. I'm like, oh God, I would do so much better if I could have like 30 minutes by myself and some music and like, anyway, but and then you just have to go in there and just do it. And it's just like, and you feel the pressure. And then of course I cry like on the spot in my real life. And then I go into an audition and I can't cry. And I'm just like, this is, if you only knew me.
And then when you leave and you can't cry, you probably cry.
I cry because I got sick. I got pissed that I couldn't cry. My mom's like, you're crying now. I'm like, I know.
But that seems like a TV phenomenon. Like,
yeah,
the expectations
it's a lot for
are...
like episodics type things. Yeah. Like with the, I don't know, CSI, all those things. Right. Like when you find someone dead or
yeah.
that kind of stuff.
I don't know many film directors who would expect you to like turn it on and off
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, they're kind of more understanding. But on television, you don't have much time to do the whole preparing thing. So it is kind of, you do need to be able to kind of turn it on. So I understand, I guess.
But it sounds like in this case, you didn't really have to prepare, or you weren't actually supposed to prepare too much for the character. You kind of found the character and then you were improvising.
It was, yeah, exactly. It was kind of the opposite. Yeah, it was the other way around, which is easy. It was fun.
So what's the hardest thing you've done as an actor?
When I was like 16, I did a horror film, and I actually turned 16 on that set, and I was like being tortured for like 2 weeks straight, fake tortured, for like 2 weeks straight, and I had to be crying for 2 weeks straight, and I just, I came home and I was thinking, okay, I've made it. I'm a real actor. And I told my agent, I was like, yeah, I don't want to do Disney and Nickelodeon anymore. And they're like, Kirby, you're only 16. What do you want to do? And I'm just like, I just want the real meaty parts.
You're going to, like, wrestle Abigail Breslin to
Yeah,
the
exactly. I was like, yeah, I've got a lot of competition, but...
What's a weird thing, how it's like certain people, just a moment happens, and then...
It's one thing can change your, you know, route, really. It's crazy. You only need one thing.
Is it intimidating to you? I mean, are you intimidated ever? You seem pretty straightforward. You seem like...
No, I'm not intimidated, because I think there's enough work out there for all of us. And if you got, you know, an opportunity before me, then that's just, you know, what happens. I'm not going to... I have no bitter... I mean, I appreciate the fact that I came out here when I did, and I know that a lot of people came out here when they were younger or were born here. I've always been told, my mom always told me, that you're always going to be in the middle. There's always going to be someone that's either less fortunate than you or is working harder than you or, you know, it's always, so I try not to compare myself to other people. That would drive me crazy too.
So how do you deal with the process of getting all these, going to auditions and doing all that? I mean, it's a business of rejection.
Yeah, I literally don't think about it anymore. I can't think about it. If I think about everything when I leave, then I don't know what I would do. I just go in, I do the best work that I can, and I leave. So and try not to think about it again.
So it's you have a process that you've developed over these years.
I don't know if I did it mindfully, but that's definitely something subconsciously that I've learned to do. To least affect my emotions, yes. Because if you get emotionally attached to something, it's very detrimental, because that's when you're getting nervous outside of the room and you can flub a line and you're just like, ah! And, you know, instead of being kind of controlled in the room and understand, okay, I don't need to actually say that word as long as I get the point across, you know. The lines aren't exactly, you know, as long as I know what I'm talking about, you know. But if I'm nervous or if I'm anxious, I'll just, in the middle of nowhere, just curse and want to leave. So it's all about keeping a very, I don't know, you have to be mindful of how you're perceived.
And now you're 21. Is your mom gone back to the rest of your family? Or?
Oh, no. She loves L.A.
Still hanging out in L.A.?
Yeah.
Do you like L.A.?
Yeah. I'm never going home.
That's understandable on some level. I mean, this is where the work is. This is where your life is.
Well, yeah,
life
no, but is. I don't even really like to when I have to. So.
Just to go see the
family? I make my family come see me.
That's always a good thing.
Which is funny, because they don't mind it. They like L.A. It's nice weather.
So have you, acculturated, is that the word I'm looking for? Have you gotten used to the social world of Los Angeles and the film business world? Is that part of your...
Yeah, I try and weave through the BS, but there's a lot of that going around.
Yes, there is.
But it's kind of ironic. I hang out with a lot of people that are from Texas that live here. There's a lot of people that moved out here from there. Anyway, so most of my friends are very loyal and genuine and keep me grounded.
Is that hard to do? Is it hard
keep
to stay grounded?
Yeah. No, not at all. And I kind of thought I was going to turn into kind of a prick after the movie, and it's actually made me more insecure. Like it's very interesting. I've kind of become even more like paranoid about like how I'm coming off. Like, I don't know. It's very interesting.
Because you have more to lose or because?
No, just because I guess people now expect something of me, or because now I've got like fans, which is super strange. People that don't even know me are complimenting me, and I just want to be like, you don't even know me. But they're being kind, and they know the person that they saw on the film, which is actually very similar. So
do you want the person you are on screen to be Kirby, or do you want to
I don't know,
be in
because
character?
Then it's like, do I want privacy, or do I want, I don't know, some of my favorite actors are the ones that I don't know anything about, like Edward Norton. I don't know who he's dating or what he's doing, like, which
we'll
makes it
later.
Easier, thanks, which makes it easier for me to watch him in films and take him seriously.
Right.
And I already kind of have a burden watching TV and film, knowing how it's done and, you know, what goes on behind the scenes. So it kind of takes away from it already. If I know who dated who, or the fact that that brother and sister got married and then divorced, and I'm just like, oh my God, how are they working together? That's all I'm thinking about. I'm not thinking about the fact that they're having a conversation about, you know, this person. And I don't know, it just takes away from it. So I would like to, you know, be a separate entity every single movie, as opposed to you being able to recognize me as the person that you see, I don't know, in tabloids.
And you've been through this press process now for a couple months.
Yeah.
Oh, the fun of that.
Yeah.
Have you already gotten that thing of where you have to draw a line between yourself and what you're allowed to give the public?
Well, there's been times where I've said I can't answer that, like if it's personal. So I'm already not talking about certain things.
And do they get grumpy when you?
No, I think they're I think they ask those questions hoping that we're not, you know, aware of the fact that we can say no, so that they can get the stuff. It's funny, sometimes I feel like they're trying to manipulate me, and I'm like, no, I'm not going to answer that, but thank you.
Well, there are a lot of actors who tell you this stuff because they want it in the tabloids. I mean,
yeah, exactly. If you don't have to talk about it unless, you know, you want to.
Have you been tabloided yet?
Oh, God, no. Oh, God.
You're not even like in the She Wore It Best or whatever that thing
oh, God,
is
no.
they do?
Oh, God, no.
Do you read any of those magazines?
No, I try not to, no. I don't like that trash.
So you're not into the fame game, it doesn't sound like.
No.
Are you a movie fan?
Yeah.
You still go?
There's a difference.
Yes, there is a huge difference.
Yes. I still go, yeah. My friend and I went to see my movie the other night.
How was that?
It was great.
Do you mind watching yourself on camera?
No, not at all. I critique myself a lot.
So that's not uncomfortable for you? You're kind of like...
It's not because I'm... Yeah, it doesn't make me feel uncomfortable. I like to learn from it, actually.
So have you always felt that way about seeing yourself work?
I've gotten a lot better at acting now, so I'm more comfortable. I remember being a little embarrassed when I was watching myself with like the one-liners on my episodics on Disney and Nickelodeon. I was just like, oh, that's bad. But yeah, you can't take anything back.
So you're hoping that'll be on Jay Leno someday in 5 years?
I really
hope
not. I did Conan, and thank God they didn't bring any of that stuff up.
And how was that experience?
Oh, it was great. It was really nice. Yeah, he's a nice guy.
Is it strange to go out there on a set and have people applauding and, you know,
I don't think any
performer?
Of them knew who I was. I swear the applause was because of that guy that holds up the sign. So, but it's fun because I got a lot of people that know who I am just because of Conan. They're like, oh, I'm going to go see Project X now. I'm like, oh, okay. They, like, just watched Conan and hadn't even heard of the movie. So I'm glad that I could have, you know, publicized the movie.
And are you feeling Project X in terms of your meetings? Are you going to a lot more meetings, a lot more... auditions and things from
you know,
it?
I'm doing about the same promoting the film and trying to get another job. So
right.
I haven't had time to really focus on getting the next job. I do test for a show tomorrow. So yeah, I've been doing okay.
Well, you know, the last time we did one of these interviews and somebody said they were testing the show for tomorrow, they got the show. So maybe
oh, please don't tell me that.
Keep my fingers
pressure,
crossed.
Pressure.
But see, that's the thing. It's interesting. You have the talking to you. You're kind of like. I'm releasing the pressure, and then it's like, oh my God, the pressure.
Well, it's just, it's interesting, because I didn't realize that it was tomorrow, and I don't know what time it is, so that gives me a little bit of anxiety, but I already know the sides. I've got them down. I'm not worried.
And what do you do when you're not doing all of this, or is this really like a five-day-a-week job?
It's not a five-day-a-week job, but I do take a lot of naps.
So you're very good at napping.
I'm very good at napping. I watch a lot of television. Like every night I'll be like, okay, what shows are on tonight? And yeah, I'm a big movie buff. I hang out with my friends.
What kind of movies do you like?
All kinds.
Besides, movies. Of course, The Hangover and
comedy.
The Hangover too.
Oh, an old school.
An old school, of course. But are you a comedy fan?
Hangover 3. Yeah, I'm a huge comedy fan. Yeah, The Big Lebowski. That's my main man.
So you watch one of these folks who watches movies over and over again?
Yeah, absolutely. I enjoy that.
So you know all the lines of The Big Lebowski? Is that...
I know a lot of them. Yeah.
So you more of a Walter
really
person, or more
together.
Of a dude person, or more?
I'm more of a dude person. Well, that's tough because I think the three of them kind of all even each other out. But
there's balance in the dude
exactly.
universe.
Exactly.
Because you're not Maude Lebowski.
No.
But can you imagine a role like
see,
that?
See, that's the thing. You could see how people would think I would be, right? And
right.
then like, I want to show that I'm not that broad.
On the other hand, doing a role like that would be a huge challenge, I would think. The idea of that, is that exciting?
I actually can play that. I just get bored with it.
Mm.
Like, I can play the stupid ditzy girl, but I just get bored with it.
But Julianne has certainly had quite an amazing career of
absolutely
a wide range of characters.
Yeah, no, she's amazing. I just and that whole naked thing that she was doing, that thing with the painting, and that's actually pretty cool.
Well, she's famously one of the few bottomless actresses in the history of Hollywood. She did a Robert Altman film 15 years ago called Shortcuts, where she was having an argument with her pants off.
Yeah, I don't plan on doing that ever.
Have you seen that film?
No, I haven't.
Do you have that history? I mean, are you a Robert Altman person? Or
no.
Are you interested in old movies? Or
yes.
Okay.
But I don't know who Robert Altman is.
He's a film. He's just a guy who made film. He's been dead for a few years, so.
That doesn't mean he's irrelevant.
No, he's incredibly relevant. You should probably actually love his films. Because in the style of Project X, he did kind of a... his thing was to kind of create an improvisational marriage between all the actors on the set.
Oh, very cool.
So he had a lot of actors who didn't do things that they, you know, they would do other kinds of movies, and they come and do an Altman movie, and it was a very different experience.
Yeah, that's what I, yeah, really that's what I like, seeing actors in different... I think being typecast, or maybe even being comfortable in a certain thing, people would do the same thing over, and it becomes very redundant.
Yeah.
So each thing, I want to do something completely, well, try to at least, different.
So do you, is the Kirby of a year ago, 2 years ago, very different than the Kirby now?
Or? Absolutely. I think I've matured a lot.
So the work probably will change, and your interest, what you're interested in, may change as you go along?
Yes. What I'm interested in changes a lot. I'm a very creative person. I like painting a lot, and then I'll like decide to do something else, and then I don't know. It's very interesting.
So it's kind of like it's just an open palette at this point that you have.
Yeah, I can't sing or dance, so it's
so
not that
see
open.
So you on Smash?
It's not no.
Or on no. What do you call it? Glee.
No.
So they have a girl on Glee now who apparently can't sing, but she's just there for.
Oh, the Vanessa Lingees. She's great.
Yeah.
She's hilarious.
But it's weird how they manage to avoid her singing always.
No, she's awful singing. She sings awfully though. But in real life, she's a good singer. But the bottom line, that's her character, is that she's really bad at singing.
And would you like to do a show like that? Would you like to do a series and
I'll do a show.
Be settled in and
I'm hungry. I'll do whatever.
The whole world is your oyster.
Oyster, yes.